me record from my side and let me share the screen. Right. So you can see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's fine. So in the last class, we discussed about the database, how to create a database, what is meant by data files, log files, how many data files will be created when you create a database, how many log files will be created when you create a database, what is auto growth in percentage, in megabytes, limited to location, physical files, logical files. Everything we discussed, right? Any issues, any doubts in the last class, guys?
No, sir.
So how many files will be created when you create a database?
Two files will be created.
What are those two files?
MDF.
MDF and?
LDF.
LDF.
Okay, MDF file and log file and data file, right? Okay, can anyone tell me the physical hierarchy of the SQL server?
Yes, sir.
Physical hierarchy, SQL server, database, file groups, extensions,
pages, tables,
In SQL Server, we will have databases. In databases, we will have file groups and log files. In file groups, we will have data files. In data files, we will have extents. In extents, we will have pages. In pages, we will have on top of the pages, the tables are going to be created. Okay. What is the page size, guys?
8KB, sir.
8KB.
What is the extent size?
64KB.
So when you create a table, SQL Server will allocate a page or an extent?
Page.
Which one it will allocate, guys? When you create a new table, SQL Server will allocate a page or an extent?
Pages only.
Okay. So, right. So whenever you create a table, new table, it will allocate a page from the extent. Okay. It will allocate a page from the extent. So we have extents, right? Again, in the extents, we have two types of extents, uniform extent, mixed extent. Okay. So we'll discuss those things later. So extent is nothing but a basic allocation unit of SQL Server. An extent is nothing but basic allocation unit of SQL Server. Page is nothing but a basic storage unit. Page is basic storage unit. Extent is basic allocation unit. So whenever you create a table, SQL Server, by default, it will allocate a page from the extent. Sometimes it will allocate the whole extent itself. Got it? If the table is big, okay? If the table is big, SQL Server will allocate the whole extent. If the table is small, usually SQL Server will allocate a page from the mixed extent for the first time. Okay? Right. Fine. So how to create the database, guys? What is the query to create the database?
Create database. Right.
Create database.
So you have to give your database name, and again, database name is going to be provided by your application team. It will mention in the ticket what database name. Okay, so that as per the ticket, you can, in case if you don't find the database name in the ticket, you can ping them. Requester will be there in the ticket who just raised the request. You can ping him directly and you can send an email to him and you can ask what would be the database name so that they will let you know. And based on that suggestion, you can create the database. Okay. So this is how we can create the database. And again, how many MDF files will be there in a database?
One.
How many LDF files will be there?
One.
Only one, sir.
How many NDF files will be there?
99.
Multiple NDF files.
Sir. Why 99? Someone said 99. Why 99? Any logic behind 99?
Depends, no, sir.
No, sir, we can create as many as possible. But you said that, for example, 99 yesterday.
As per record,
I remember that.
NDF file.
Okay, so there is no 99. Okay, so again, NDF files are optional. Okay, if you want, you can add extra data files, secondary data files. If you don't want, no need to add. It's not mandatory, but MDF and LDF are mandatory for database. NDF is not mandatory. If you want, you can add extra data files, okay? Based on the situation, yesterday we discussed in what situations we are going to add extra data files, in what situations we are going to disable the auto growth, right? So we discussed everything in the last class, right? Fine. So let me create a table today. Anji, you have recording permissions, you can record, okay? So let me open new query window. Right, so I just want to create a table. Okay, so I just want to create a table, any table, small table. We'll start with a small table and all, right? So what are the main inputs for the tables, guys? If you want to create any table, forget about SQL Server, in Excel sheet you want to create one table, one student table.
Rows and columns.
Tell me, yeah.
Rows and columns.
Student table, imagine what would be the columns, appropriate columns for the student table, guys.
Name,
very good. Yes, very good.
Address,
address, very good.
Father name,
father name, very good. Phone number, very good.
Student class details,
class details. Good.
Keys, very good. Grades.
Okay, grade, fine. Very good. Okay, so these are all the different inputs for a student table, right? So we'll take 2 to 3 inputs and we are going to create one table. Okay, so let's create a table. So what is the query to create the, in case if you want to create the table using GUI, I'll let you know. Usually tables and all we will create using query only. The best option is query only. By using GUI also we can do it. Okay, so let's create a table using query. Okay, so for that, what we are doing, we are going to create one table, right? So for create any object, we have to start query with a create statement. Create
table,
what you
table
want to
name.
Create table, right?
Table.
So table. So you have table to mention name. Table name, right? If you mention table,
student.
You have to mention table name, right? Student. Okay. Create table, table name, student. So in case as discussed just now, we have to provide the columns, right? What columns and all it should be included in the table. We have to provide columns, right? We'll include 2-3 columns, okay? Let me open these brackets to include the columns. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to include a student ID, SID. SID, this is like student ID, okay? SID means student ID. And again, see, SID is like only for our purpose. Okay, or else simply you can mention STUID, okay, student ID. Okay, student ID. So guys, remember one thing. For example, if you go to any shop, Sunil, query is the best method, okay, not GUI. Remember one thing, okay, GUI is only limited to some of the operations, not for all the operations. I would suggest query only, as query is easy. Okay. GUI, if you want to create table using GUI, there are, why? Because we are discussing a small table. Imagine in the organization, you will have 20 columns table, 30 columns table and all. It is very difficult to manage with GUI. Okay. Very basic level guys will create the tables with GUI. You are a professional after this training. Okay, you have to keep at least 4 to 5 years of experience or 3 to 5 years of experience. Then you are a professional. We don't use, professionals don't use GUI option for creating the tables and all. Remaining things will depends on, okay, GUI only. But creating tables and all, we don't prefer, okay, this GUI method. Fine? Right. So student ID. Say, for example, if you go to any shop, so you want to buy milk. Okay, so you want to buy milk. So how you are going to ask them, you need a 1 liter milk or 2 liters milk, like you are going to ask like that. You won't ask 1 kg milk, 2 kg milk, right? you won't ask 1 liter bananas or 2 liter bananas, right? So for every product, there are some denominations, okay? So you have to ask in that way only. Milk, you are going to calculate in the form liters. Of liters. Okay, this fruits and all, might be you can calculate in kgs or else like as per the local denomination, what is the local denomination and all, right? So this is how it will work. You won't ask, okay, 1 liter bananas or 1 liter apples, right? So for everything, there is a denomination. The same way, if you want to include student ID, if you want to include student ID, we are going to mention data type, which data type it has to accept, which data Indeed. Type it has to accept. So usually student ID is a numbers, right? It is going to accept numbers, right? So in case if you want to accept any numbers kind of things, okay, usually we have data types, different data types, guys. Okay, so we have integer data type, we have char data type, we have varchar data type, we have varchar of max, okay, var binary max, time, date, money, float, double. Okay, so and what else we are missing? Char, varchar, text data type.
Yes.
Okay. Text data type.
String.
Date, time, string. Okay. So these are all different data types that developers are going to use. Data types means simply the measurements. How we are going to measure this value? Student ID, it can't be float or double, right? Or money, right? It can't be float or double or money. Okay, float means what? In case we have decimals. Decimal is also one data type. Decimal. Okay, student ID is not going to be decimal. Student ID, you cannot see 1.1, 1.2 student. You cannot see like that, right? So integer, in case if any numbers are there, if you want to represent the numbers, you can go with the integer data types, guys. Why? Because the student ID column has to accept only numbers. If you mention integer here, it won't accept anything. It will accept only numbers. You have to insert only numbers in the student column.
Sir, already float means it takes decimal values, right, sir? Why we have to take again decimal?
See, decimal, there is a separate value for decimal and float also. That can be, you just go and check it, okay? We are not going to discuss all these things, okay? We are going to discuss basic data types. So what is the exact difference between float and decimal? You can check it, okay? So even I'm also not sure. Why? Because I'm not good in development. Okay. Right.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So student ID, it has to accept only integers, okay? Right. So like this, for every column, we have to mention data types. For student name, what would be the data
integer.
Type? Student name.
Name should be character.
Yes. As student name, yes. You can go for character or varchar. Mostly we'll go for varchar. Okay. So student name. Usually if you are mentioning about the character values, string values, right? Your names, locations, whatever you want. If you are my address. Okay. So in such case, you can go for varchar. Okay. So for every... you have to remember one thing. Every column needs a data type, guys. What is the type of data you are going to insert in that column? You have to mention the data type. Okay. So if you are mentioning this integer, it is going to accept only integers, like 1, 2, like we have numbers, right? Integers. Okay. So it won't accept characters and all. If you mention integer, it won't accept any other values. It will accept only numbers. If you just mention character or varchar, it will accept, okay, whatever you can say, numbers. And your, if you go for characters, it will accept only characteristics. If you mention character, char data type, it will accept only characteristics. If you mention varchar, it will include your numbers and characters also. For example, address. Address includes numbers and characters. Door number, house number, street number. right? And again, you will have your address, right? So in such case, you can go for where care data type. So mostly names will go with the where care. Any numbers will go with the integers. Date and all, if you want to mention dates, say for example, date of birth of student, you want to include DOB, date of birth of the student, then you can include this date data type. Okay. So in that money, for example, you want to include fees. You want to include fee column for the particular student, then you can mention money data type so that it will accept only numericals, only numbers it is going to accept, right? So data type means the type of data it is going to accept for every column while creating the table, while creating, not every time guys, only while creating the table, you have to include column names and what type of data this column has to accept. You have to include those two values, column name and what type of data it has to accept. So every column, again, you can see a data type. Student ID, I am going to mention integer for the student ID. Okay, so that it is going to accept integer data type. Student name, simply I'm giving S name. S name means student name. So what I'm going to give where care of something like 100. 100 means it is going to accept up to 100 characters. Okay, Shiva, S-H-I-V-A, how many? 5 characters. Ramu, 4 characters. Vasu, 4 characters. So like that, it is going to accept up to 100 characters. How many characters you need, you have to mention in the brackets. So someone will have very big names, right? So for that, at least we are going, the best case is 100 we are going to mention. Why? Because in case if you have very big name and all, we can accommodate with this 100 characters. Okay, so this is how we have to manage how much you want to give. If you give 50, it will accept up to 50 characters only. Where care 50, it will accept up to 50. If you give 5, you cannot, okay, insert your name more than 5 characters. Suresh, S-U-R-E-S-H, 6 characters. If you give 5 here, it won't accept. Why? Because up to 5, it is going to accept.
Like a storage, sir?
Yes.
I mean,
kind of, okay. Yes. Okay, so like this, you have to include. So usually it will be 100. And again, guys, nothing to worry here if you don't understand. But it's important to understand how to create tables and all. Usually in the organization, we don't get these tickets. Okay, as a DBA, what we are going to do, sometimes developers won't have permissions to execute, create database scripts, or sometimes they might not have permissions to create the tables. Then in that case, they will write the script, they will ask us to execute that script. So script and all will be prepared. Okay, so what data types we have to give, what columns we have to give, no need to worry about these things. These things will be taken care by the developers. They will create a meeting and they will discuss in the meeting what would be the column names and all, what would be the data types and all, everything they will discuss in the meeting. And then they are going to create these tables. So it's the responsibility of the developers. But as a DBA, you should know at least basic things, how to create a table and all. Okay. Again, nothing to worry about this data types and all. Just try to understand. If you don't understand, okay, that's not an issue at all. Just basic knowledge is required. As a DBS, okay, you have to understand, right, how they are going to create tables and all, right? So we are not going to create any table. In case if there are some chances, they will ask us to execute the existing scripts to create the tables. Simply copy paste that script and you can click on execute button. Tables will be created. No need to do any changes. Okay, so nothing to worry what column names I have to give, what data types I have to choose, how much value I have to give in this brackets and all, nothing to worry. Okay, guys, clear? Right. So let me include one more column. Okay. And this time I will include fee column. Fee, the data type would be money.
Money.
Okay. So I am just creating this table, student table, with how many columns, guys?
Three columns.
Student ID, second one is student name, third one is fee. Okay. So I'm just creating table with the 3 columns. That's it. Okay. So what you can do, guys, so remember, guys, this is very important. Okay, so whenever you are executing this query, very, very, very important thing, very important thing, very, very important thing, on which database you are executing this script. Guys, tell me on which database I'm executing this script now.
Master database.
Here you can see which database is, like, it is showing here. you are executing the script in that particular database. Or else you can see here also, this section or this section. You can see here or here. Guys, this is very important. So you are not supposed to create tables wherever you want. You are not supposed to run the scripts wherever you want. You are not supposed to execute the scripts wherever you want. For every action, the important thing is on which database you want to do this action. Very important, guys. Very, very important. Very, 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 very important. Why? Because instead of this, say, for example, I want to create this table, okay, in batch 40. But you are creating table in the master database. This is just a creation, no problem, no impact. But imagine you want to delete some tables from batch 40. But unfortunately, you ran that query in the Amazon database. What will happen, guys?
The Amazon data will be lost.
Right. So we are going to lose the data. At the end of the day, we are going to lose the money. That's it. We are going to lose that one also. Everything. Okay. So that's why, guys, very important. Whenever even a select query or create query, an insert query, update query, delete query, whatever query it is, make sure on which database you're executing this query. Sometimes, okay, even experienced DBAs also forget, they will forget about this. And it's very common, okay? So sometimes we don't see on which database we are executing, simply copy paste and will directly execute it. It will create a lot of impact, guys, believe me. Okay, so sometimes you cannot expect also lot of issues will come, okay? So that's why whenever you are writing any query, guys, once the query is completed, two things you have to do. One is whether this query is right or wrong. You just use your path button. Second thing is on which database I'm executing. So even though if you miss this, not an issue. If it is wrong, it will throw the error. But if you miss this on which database you're executing the query, that's it. Okay. So let me create the database. Let me create this table in the batch 40. I want to change the database. I can change it from here. Okay. Select batch 40. And then I can now create the table so that this table will be created in the batch 40. Okay, so how to change the database? Simply click on this, and whatever database you want to write this query, you want to create the table and all, simply select that particular database and you can execute it. Now the table is going to be created. And if you just expand this batch 40, if you expand the tables and all, okay, now you can see student table. Right, you cannot see in any of the databases, guys. As you created the table in the batch 40, only in the batch 40 you can see the table. See here, in the Amazon, there are no tables. If any user tables are there, you can see after this graph tables. Here you can see after this graph tables, you can see the table, right? If any user created tables are there, then you can see all the tables here under graph, not under graph tables. Okay, if you see the graph tables is a separate object, and other than that, you can see one more object, tables. If you have one more table, you can see one more entry here. So like that it will be. There are no user tables here. You can see there are no tables after the graph tables and all. Okay, so it's very important, guys, on which database you're executing query, even though it is a select query. Sometimes select query, you're running the select query. Okay, say for example, let me run select query in the master database. Or Amazon database, select as I created. If I want to read the data in the table, I have to use select query. Select, I want to read all the columns, right? Select star from table name is what? Student. Okay, so if you just run this query, what I'll get, guys?
All the rows in the...
Oh, Amazon, we don't have any
table.
Okay, so if you execute this table, you will get an error, invalid object name. Student, what is this? Invalid object name. Object means what? Table. Invalid table name, student. Why it is throwing this error? Why? Because we executed this query in the Amazon database. In the Amazon, we don't have this student table. If you just change this database to batch 40, and if you execute again, then you can see all the columns, whatever columns we have created, we can see the columns. Why? Because we haven't inserted any value till now. You can see the table structure only. This is your table structure. Okay, how many columns are there? Three columns are there.
Three.
So this is how you can manage. Okay, so again, even though it is a select query, make sure on which database you're executing. This is very important, guys. This is very, very important. Sometimes, okay, people will lose the jobs by just doing the small mistakes and all. Okay. So again, be very careful before executing whatever query it is. Check it on which database I am running this query. Okay. Right. Fine. Okay. So let me insert, as we have created the table. Now let me insert some records in this particular table. Okay. So what is the query to insert the records?
Insert
query. As I am going to insert the records, insert into, in which table I want to insert?
Student.
Give the table name. And what I want to insert?
Values.
Okay, in the bracket. Okay. So just simply give one and go with your mentioning about the names, okay, make sure you are giving string values here. This is string. Okay, any name you can call it as a string. Okay, if you are mentioning strings, make sure you are giving these quotes, single quotes. Okay, so let's go with this. Okay, Ravi. Okay, just close the single quotes. Okay, so any name you have to mention like this only, guys. Why? Because sometimes, okay, it will be, name will be like this. Okay, Surya Prakash. If you mention like this, it will treat it as one name. But if you don't include the single quotes, it will treat it as two values. Okay, this value it will treat it as student name. This value it will treat it as money. Three values, right? This value it will treat it as student name, and this value it will treat it as money. Money means fees. Sorry, fee column. Okay, this value it will treat it as fee column, and it is going to throw the error. It won't execute. So that's why you cannot expect what would be the name and all. So you can mention string values like this. Okay, so that it is going to treat the whole name as one student name, and you can mention something around 50,000. Okay, now you can close the brackets. Until you close the brackets, it will throw the error here. See here, you can see red line, right? You can close it, then this red line will go disappear. Okay, so it will be like this. So you have to include whatever column names you in the table. Three column names are there, you have to include three values, guys. Five columns are there in the table, you have to include all five values here. Even though if you miss one column value also, it won't take by default value. It will simply throw the error. In these three values, if I missed this fee, it will throw the error. Why? Because exact columns, how many columns are there? Three columns are there. But how many I'm inserting? How many columns I'm inserting? Two values I'm inserting. Column definition is not matched. As per the column
definition, put nil instead of that
anything. Okay, so anything, but you cannot left it blank. Okay, you cannot ignore it. You can put it as null also, not nil. Okay, null. Okay, so put null also, but not an issue. But the thing is, at least you have to include null. If you don't include anything, simply as per the table definition, three columns are there, but you are inserting only two column values or one column value, so it will simply throw the error. Sunil, wait. Okay. Insert some more values means you're asking records.
Yes,
you're asking records, or do you want me to insert some more values here? I have to continue this line. Okay. So this is one record, guys. And you can see here. Okay. So let me insert this record and then we'll continue with the records and all. Okay. Now let me execute and you can see one row affected. As you just ran it for one time, you can see one row affected. Okay. Even if you run it for 100 times also, you can see one row affected, one row affected, one row affected. Like that, you will get output for 100 times. One row affected, one row affected, one row affected, one row. Like that, you will get the output. Not 100 rows affected. You don't see 100 rows affected. So guys, can I run this query again to insert the second record? Or I'll get the error as student name. This Surya Prakash is already there. I need answers from you guys. Can I insert Surya Prakash record one more time? Or I'll get the error as one Surya Prakash 50,000 values are already inserted. I need answers from
you. We won't get, sir.
We won't get any error.
Chart. Can I insert? Yes. No, I cannot insert. No. What is the answer? Yes or no?
Please repeat the question, sir.
Can I insert the same record again in the table, or it will throw the error as I am not changing any values, any column values and all? Sheikh, I'll explain. Okay, Bashir, I'll explain that one. So the answer,
you have to change the number, sir. Otherwise, it will cause to return Excel.
Okay, so data. Otherwise it will throw the error.
Yes.
Okay.
No, sir. We can insert same name, same ID.
At least one column should be different, sir. At least.
Okay, fine. Let's discuss.
Okay. Without using any conditions, we can.
Yes, okay. So let me reconnect this meeting. Let me close and let me reopen. Please join immediately with the same link.